foca tant en tant. Maura? No. Another outsider. Seems the Oracle needs to tighten her guard.
Be on your guard. This man is a wizard.
Name yourself, then. Out with it now. Do you think me a fool? Meyerwald is the Watcher of Cadnua. For whatever good that ruined hovel has done him.
I fixed it up real nice, too. Can't say so.
Years? Years, then. Maura spoke true after all. Little matter. Allow me an idle moment's curiosity. Have you heard of the Archmage Fionn Legge? You truly do not recognize me. Then the effect is not localized. Neither limited to mine own mind, nor to Maura's. Unless, perhaps, could the Hand Occult have developed some manner of... Ah, it seems the Hoarder stirs. Pleasant dreams, outsider.
Of Engwith truly know no but.
Well, it sure don't look friendly.
Boudicca's ashy old cap. Mayhaps we ought to be putting a poor bastard.
I say we guard them to the light.
You have to help! Protect him!
You have seen what cannot be unseen!
Please,
there is no salvation. Dream forever, sleeper!
Thank you.
cleaving it to the brisket.
This is futile!
Thank you.
pleasure. This is futile!
The entity collapses in a pile of wrinkled flesh and gaping maws, expiring with an expulsion of fetid breath from deep within. Essence fl-
Truly? That's the Titan's key? But that's-
Within the flow of souls, you find the gem-like sparkle of something precious. Something core to the creature. Or to something consumed by the creature. It slips into you. With sudden clarity, you see a vast orifice blooming open. Blood-slick tendrils unfurling from its depths. Stairs rise from within Wael's titanic body, called by a specific memory pulsing within. Sacrifice to. A machine set among shelves of innumerable books. The vision fades, leaving you shaken. It was a key, you think. That now resides within your psyche. If you found this device, this Trephine, you believe you could activate it. Your voice echoes in the darkness.
Reminds me of a wedding I went to once.
That's what I was gonna say.
What foul magic creates a creature like that?
Yeah, that foul soul rot be more cleared up now than not.
Thank you.
Hey, so why do I try so hard at keeping you alive if you're just going to go sticking your arm down whatever that is?
This isn't a test you need pass, Watcher. No one holds a needle to your throat. One of Aeora's greatest wonders, and it's infested with eyeballs. Lovely.
Bathed by shadows. Greetings, visitor. This is the Scriptorium. If you seek the Temple of Revelation, you will find it to the north. Because you must. It is entry and exit. Much of what can be found here better remains unseen. Sight is unnecessary for the ask what you seek. The Scriptorium was recently breached by one of the subjects from the collections. There is nothing to be concerned about, but it might impact the demeanors of those present. How else might I help you? Perhaps, if the wizard has procured a mask for himself, did you encounter him? I'm afraid not.
The individual in question's record has been expunged.
A wizard of his standing is not so easily removed from history. Much like a tumor, bits of him are no doubt everywhere.
She generally limits her excursions to the archives, though she was recently working at the Trephine. She respects our work, so the Oracle allows her limited access to the archives and scriptorium, the Oracle of Well. They manage the halls in the name of He Who Sees, and if the Oracle wishes to commune with you, they will of the scriptorium, in a manner of speaking. Of the halls obscured, that would be the Oracle. I will provide what answers I can. We record what occurs within the hall. Whereas the wings contain those things redacted from the world above, the scriptorium keeps the archives contain the sum whole of the Husfava. They contain a number of unusual and interesting artifacts. The collections store those individuals and creatures determined to be detriment. Rather than allow the redacted materials to go to waste, we revise and anthology.
You be talking about people, you sodden eyeless fuck. Not goddamn books of history.
A womb, perhaps, but not the fetus. The hand occult no more possesses a set decades. I would have to consult the records to provide. Her interest lay in the arcane applications of the Titan.
That is hardly comforting.
How else might I help you? The Titan rests beneath the facility. Its ties to the halls obscured have grown, of course, as are you, as am I.
Captain. Aye, aye. Heavy bullet, our cap.
Real quiet now.
What for, cap? Ooh, have yourself a look at that, mate. A lord's foot and an heavy bullet, our cap.
Give me a real challenge.
Thank you.
I'll see what I can find.
What can I do you for? Yeah?
Hey, it's looking at me. And also at you.
Greetings, visitor. How else might I help you?
quite fantastic, that. Don't seem the least bit trap-like.
Table the discussion for a second, Len. It seems the collection spat out our mutual friend in one piece. And it spat you out with company. The prisoners who survived the ordeal can start anew. Aeora needs more good ideas out in the wild, don't you think?
Have you made any headway in locating our wayward archmage?
You raise an interesting point. How would you even know if the collections had gotten under your... Can you trust anything you wrote in that journal you carry around? You know what? Ignore my ramblings. If you got it down on parchment, then I'm sure your account is verifiable.
No progress on Maura, then. Maura is tenacious and reckless. She won't hesitate to unleash horror upon the world if it would serve her. I encourage you to hurry.
While you were on Maura's trail, we've learned a bit more about our unusual environs. A finger of the Hand Occult has kept this place going with a skeleton crew of librarians, archivists, and muscle. But they aren't the ones controlling the body. Something else is running the halls obscured independently, doing a decent job of it.
Your definition of what constitutes decency is dubious at best.
Well, these halls are more lively than most of the abandoned sanctums I've visited. Something here is invested in maintaining old projects. Whoever they are, they haven't seen fit to show their face.
Stay on task, Tane. Regardless of how interesting this sanctum's keepers may be, Maura's whereabouts remain our chief concern. Given Maura's proclivities, your best option is likely to be...
As you approach the pool, an unpleasant weight grows in the pit of your stomach. A whirling vortex of essence twists within the pool. It does not. Langrath and Tane watch you from afar, the latter's expression bright with undisguised curiosity. Its cold, dusky energy feels somehow familiar, but you're unable
to. Looks like water to me.
Unusual arcane energy emanates from the pool. If the Watcher can see it...
That was my second guess.
There'll be something there for sure, Cap. Can I tell you what's on account of me only sensing the shadow?
Feels real old and quiet, Watcher. Like a doorway to an ancient tomb.
You think maybe it's the soul of some fish? Hey, Watcher, fishes got souls, don't they? Yeah, of course they do. Easy to forget that sometimes. Good to be reminded, though, of everything we're fighting for.
It reaches back towards you. Tendrils of soul energy interlacing with the prodding edges of your... The coils of essence tighten, grasping at your soul, pulling at you as you've pulled the souls of others. The walls, the pool, everything of the Temple of Revelation runs like water, sloughing away and melting into the empty blackness of the in-between.
You think it can see us?
Ah, another involuntary invitation to another world.
Don't suppose any of you be knowing what in the name of Wow's hidden fiddly bits that ball of blinkers?
Certainly ain't the kind of eyes a gal wants to get lost in.
What are you, interloper? Obviously, that is not the knowledge we seek.
You think it says we, so it don't have to be saying.
You intrude upon the resting place of Wow and soil these collections with your filthy fingers. We would know. Are you one more wizard in pursuit of unearned power? Death's touch finds no welcome in these halls. You have proven yourself a murderer. We cannot allow you to enter the body, nor to visit harm upon it. Your destructive trespass within these walls cannot be forgiven.
Leaving it to the brisket.
Helpful.
Chopping you to chum, chum.
Oh. waterfall? That's not very helpful.
Hey there.
Yeah.
Dragon's icy bollocks. Keep it in your fucking pants, eyeball.
Unacceptable. You disrupt our precious library. Spoil our artifact. Fine! Go! We interfere no further! Go! Flee!
Okay there? Looking a little rough around the edges.
I suppose I should have expected Wael would leave something behind to guard this place. For now, you must get to the archives. So long as Maura has free reign of this place, Eora...
What you want, Groundstink? Got something you want to forget, huh? Want to escape? New drugs ready for sampling. Sleep with... Want baubles? You give me masked fetid spray is complacency will be my terrible ill plots against.
Did you need some?
Of course, you're the one who gave me back the stars. Yet you don't need to worry about me. Even if I might not always know your face. These two were bringing me up to speed on your...
Just because we don't announce our actions from the roof of Kahanga Palace doesn't mean...
Well, no one invited me to get involved in the Aethys problem. I just...
Before I forget... Again, here. Some things I picked up on my way back from the collections. It's not much, but it's all I could scrounge together. I never touch this stuff. They give me bad dreams. I lost more than my senses in this place. You've covered a lot of ground, so it can't hurt to ask. When I got here, someone without a face ripped him out of my clutches. I've been worried sick ever since. My little book friend. We've been through a lot together, and we both have the creases to show for it. His spine is a little bent, and my index a few pages short.
Do you think she's given her grimoire a name as well?
Agrasima. I know that finding one specific book in this place, books tend to flow through the archives. I would go there myself. But I cannot fight the faceless ones holding any... The stars shine down on us always, but we hardly know them at all. And the stars remind me of my smallness in the wider world. Our wars and our... For me, magic is the same. Humbling. I suppose I'm inspired by the unbearable size and mystery of it. That island lies in some disputed waters. One day, Rautai launched a colony ship to fortify the beaches. Onekaza held an open court to negotiate territory rights. I was the only petitioner who did not represent one of her enemies. And she thought it would be very funny if the trading companies... She even helped me finance the observatory and donated 10 crates full of books. Onekaza visits whenever she can make the time. She loves to stargaze. Agrasima. As much as I wish to return to my observatory, I have no intention of...
Freedom is long overdue for those poor wretches in the collections. Now they're leaving the nest. Oh, my little thought bombs are all grown up. The Hand Occult uses this place to rewrite history, obscure the truth, and spin fiction into reality. Now, we've tried to wrote a fringe benefit into our spell. The prisoners who knew too much might feel extra talkative once they return to society. All it took was sipping a few motes of power from Wal's body. Definitely not. Extremely unlikely. I suppose anything's possible. No need to be glum. Whatever scheme the Hand Occult wanted to accomplish here, we've set it back. All kinds of secrets. Wars that should or shouldn't have started. Scandals. The kinds of things you learn from peering through the wrong keyhole. Not knowing is the real fun of the thing. I'm not saying it was. Theirs might be a carefully organized plan to steer us toward a better future by embellishing some facts and can you say you've met a single person who deserves that kind of authority? I sure can't. And I'm tame. Occupational hazard. You should consider early retirement, hanging up the old cloak. Maybe get yourself a nice castle. Oh, right. Sorry. I found these beauties tucked away and thought you might give them a good home. There were more at first, but I lost a few to a juggling accident. I'd be surprised if most of the Hand even knows that this place exists. They want the world to think they write travel guides and circulate pamphlets of local history. Not even the Hand could tell you which facts they edited for conveniences. That is a head-scratcher. I suppose the solution is to be skeptical. You have to ask yourself, how much do you trust anything in a book? Does a story become more true because someone paused to write it down? I should really charge for discourse this engaging.
If we're to be indulging outsized egos, I'd rather listen to Isilmir's prattle.
If they ever had one, you can bet they've changed it a dozen times over the years. Anyone who wants to control information on that scale, whatever they plan on doing with that power, You can bet they'll lose control over it in the end.
Some speak of the Hand Occult as hyper-competent masters of four-dimensional Hazatoa. When they know, in truth, the Hand's operations are haphazard and ill-executed. We know that they succeed in spite of themselves is hardly evidence of the Hand's competence.
Amateurs. Time and again, their agents showed up at my doorstep and wormed their way into my confidence, hoping to sabotage. I sent them home with bags of their own teeth, as a parting reminder that my time is precious and my patience thin.
Ask away. You know me. I'm an open book with plenty of pictures.
So you've freed those poor souls held captive here. What will become of them, I wonder? I doubt if Tain has any... Well, there's no undoing what you've done. I pray the Pallid Knight grants them...